Okay, installing LED lights, that side's done. Now we're going to do that one this weekend. This is an aluminium tray, so that means that that's separate from the car. This wasn't manufactured by the manufacturer of the car. This is a 1995 Holden Rodeo. However, as I've said, this is a separate unit. This work, you know, you would think that it would be very easy to do, right? You've got the LED light, make up a bracket, put the LED light on, and wire it up. Yes, that's true. However, things can go very pear-shaped with this work. The main thing to do, if you're putting LED lights like this on your car, because we're talking about reverse, driving, brakes and indicator, is you've got to have the color code for that LED setup. I've noticed with this same model of LED there, that there can be different color codes and different colored wires, so that's the main core of this job, is to have a color chart. I highly recommend going into a shop like Super Cheap Auto. I can't recommend Repco, because I feel that I've been ripped off there price wise a few times, but I'd go into a shop for this. I wouldn't get it on eBay, because chances are it'll come without its color chart. Okay, the next thing to do is launch into this sea of information here. So that's my notes. I will go through these notes in a sec. If you can't read my writing, then I'll explain it now. Okay, so you get the gist of it. It can get complicated. Okay, I'll go through this as quickly as possible. With this car, the reason that I've decided to put the LEDs on is because the bulbs were reliable. So that's the standard one. That's 25 years old now. And what happened was, I was replacing some bulbs, but then I didn't check it one weekend. And the next weekend I check it, both brake bulbs weren't working. I think the driving lights, I think the brakes were working. So that's why I've decided to do something about it and put these LED lights on. Okay, that's the LED light there. That's the one we're putting on today. And I highly recommend siliconing around the edge there. Okay, if you don't do that, then moisture will get in. I've also siliconed around the front there. I taped off around the edge and silicone, so I didn't get any silicon on the lens there. So that's silicon, and on the back is silicon. If you don't do that, in my experience, you'll get condensation on the inside there, and that'll affect the life of the LED light. That's what was happening here. You can see there's rain on there. It's been outside, and yet because I've siliconed around this edge, then there's no condensation on the inside there. Second to having the color chart, it's important to establish what is the driving and brake lights. Okay, so I'll demonstrate that later on. So what we're going to do is, at the brake light assembly, we're going to cut on the inside. I'll just go around to the other one. Okay, so here, that's the brake light there, brake light assembly. We're going to cut one of these wires. One's the driving wire, one's the brakes, and we're going to find out what's driving and what's brakes. It's very, very important to label these wires up. If things go wrong, remember to check your fuses. Okay, so if you've got a cross wire, the color chart's not right or whatever, keep on checking your fuses, because I had to replace a few with this one here. On this vehicle, the fuse boxes are here, under the steering wheel and here in under this box, and there's a wiring diagram there. I cannot recommend using LED lights where there's snow. Okay, if you live in a cold area and the snow, these LED lights, in my experience, don't, or from what I can gather, they don't produce any heat. Okay, so a globe produces heat and it'll melt the snow. Okay. Another important thing to consider is, don't do this for looks. If you've got globe lights and they're working and fairly reliable, so you have to replace a globe every now and then, keep them, you know, don't change them. But with me, these became a little bit too unreliable, and that's why I'm doing something about it now. I found I can no longer buy globe light clusters like this. Okay, so around here, and I'm in Sydney, that's another thing. So you can no longer buy globes, they only sell LEDs, and I can't find globes on eBay. With this work, it's a good idea to put the battery on charge. The reason for that is, if you wire it up and you turn all your lights on and it doesn't work, okay, then you're in trouble, all right? And you're going to do things like, you're going to leave your headlights on, you're going to go up to the computer to try and find something out, and they'll stay on and all the rest of it. So just as a bit of side information here, if you've got a hobby bike and a hobby car, by the way, I don't know who owns who here, whether I own this truck or it owns me, but that's another thing. Always keep them on, the batteries on charge, because what'll happen is you'll start them up after, say, you know, 4 or 6 months, the battery will be low, it'll place too much load on your alternator. Okay, and your alternator is going to get burnt out, so you're going to have a flat battery, the alternator is not going to work, and that's not good. So keep the battery on charge. When you do the mock-up for the wiring, to hold the wires together that you've just twisted together, use this paper tape. If you use the electrical tape, this will it just falls off, whereas I think this has got more adhesion. You're going to need fuses. As I say, if you wire it up, as far as you can tell, all correct, and you come back out here and find that it's all cross-wired, like you put the indicator lights on and the brake lights are flashing, then you're in trouble, okay? And you could blow fuses, so you'll need fuses. Another important thing, for the reverse lights to come on, the engine's going to have to be running, and this is in a manual, the engine's going to have to be running and the gear stick will have to be in the reverse position, okay, not in any other position. So yeah, the main thing is the engine has to be running in a manual, or at least on this car, and the gear stick has to be in reverse for the reverse lights to come on. So it's important to label up the wires, like where they come from, and establish what's the brake and what's the driving lights wires. This is a wiring diagram for my LED lights. So that's, the black is the negative, and that goes to the black wire on this truck. So on this side, your wires are going to be different because not everybody uses the same wires or wire colors when they manufacture this. Okay, go up to the computer now. I'll show you where I got this LED light from, and hopefully some of the possible other wiring color codes. I know there's a lot of information at the start of this video, but you know, if things go wrong, you're gonna have to know this stuff. Okay, just very quickly, that's my LED there. That's the cellar. So we'll just scan through here and we'll see there's no color code anywhere there. Okay. So there's one possible color code. I'll just go back to my LED lights and just check there. Yeah, with mine, as we can see, they're all, there's no color codes there, and no color codes there. There's another color code from another LED light. That's that one there. There's another color code, so you get the idea. They're all different. Same as mine, but I don't think I've got the brown. So yeah, problem. The mounting plate is that's 100 by 187 wide millimeters. This hole here is 6.5 millimeters. That's for the bolts to go through. However, this hole here is going to be a bit of a challenge. That's to bring the wire through, and this grommet here has to pass through it. My best guess is that that's 10 millimeters. And I had to use this drill with a chuck in it to get that done. Okay, this bracket is riveted in three places along the top. Okay, first of all, got to establish what wire is brakes and what wire is driving. So I know from this that the driving is red-green, and the other ones, the brakes are green, so that's brakes and that's driving. So okay, what I'm going to do here is cut the green, not too close because there's a chance I may have to put this light assembly back, so I'll cut it about there. Okay, so with ignition on, that is indeed the driving light still connected. So just to be clear, with the ignition on and the lights on, the driving lights are on. Okay, so the cut wire, the one I've just cut with the scissors, I've labeled that up as brakes. Now every globe has a ground going to it, so that might not be showing up too well there. That black wire is the ground there. So with the LED lights, it's just got one main ground wire, so you don't run the ground to every globe. So I'll just put a G on this for good luck, but that's black. Black is ground on this side of the car side, not the LED side. Okay, so that's it. The wire cluster here is now separate from the light assembly. Okay, so what have we got there? We've got reverse on the left hand side. We've got indicator, and we've got driving and brakes. Okay, so now this has to come off. And last time these bolts wouldn't release because that's 25 years old. So I think I came around the front, and what I did was I literally drilled around the bolt. Although on this one it seems different. There's no bolt. Okay, well anyway, I removed that and let you know how I did it. You can see that the plastic's cracking there, getting old. Not so much on this side, it's not too bad. It looks like I've done some silicon work there. There would have been a break or a gap in that. I'll fix that up with silicon. But anyway, oh, this is interesting. This one's got a rubber flap. The light on that side didn't have this, so somebody's removed that in their wisdom, and that's the bolts there connecting in behind there. Well, that's not used, of course, but this at the top here. So this is an upside down right hand unit. Okay, it's a bit complicated because I've got this reverse light going into this cluster now. Do I need the reverse light now? No, because these LED lights, they put out a fair amount of light. The reverse light actually gives you the amount of light you need to back, like the old days. All you had was a globe. But anyway, I'm going to keep it because, you know, you don't know. For instance, one of the other reverse lights might fail. But anyway, so there's reverse there. The ground, I'm going to keep connected to this cluster here that goes to the reverse light. The brakes, the indicators, and driving lights. Just make sure that these stay on, just keep on sort of pushing them up as far as they'll go so that they don't fall off. Okay, 4mm rivets, that goes into the 4mm but not the, the 3. And I'm going to use the existing holes here, so I'm just going to drill these out. Don't forget to put your batteries on charge before you need them. Okay, I've got the center of my bracket, that's there, and that's from that inside there behind the light there. That's 13 centimeters from there to the middle there. This is different from the other side. I've got this and that on that side. On this side, this has somehow been removed or come off. But this is the actual mounting plate for the other one. And I've measured from this because that's constant from there to there. So I've got that on the other side. Okay, that's the name of the game. That's what I've got to replicate on the other side there. So I've got the middle there, I've got my mark. So I've just got to put that middle rivet in, and then I can get it level and put the other two in. I'd like to make the point that I start this job on a Saturday morning, so I'm assuming you've got 2 days weekend. Definitely start it on Saturday morning, because if things don't go right, you're going to need that Sunday to get it going again. Okay, just make sure that you've got this orientated the right way, not like that or like that. And then I've lined it up with my line-up mark in the middle there. And I've gone up and I've used whiteout because my paint pen won't pass through that hole. Okay, I'll use a center punch and just make a punch in the middle of that hole there. You're going to need a brand new drill bit preferably, but at the very least a good drill bit to drill through there. It's actually fairly difficult to get up under there. Okay, that's how I stopped the bracket from moving. I just got a vice grip, and that kept it stable while I got the left one in. Now I'll put the right one in. Okay, the mounting plate is on, the rivets are in, and I didn't actually line it up with the back. I lined it up with the front here. We can see that as this falls down, if you like, it lines up with this. I'm assuming this is level. I better check that. Okay, this sticker is level, and as this drops, you'll see that it lines up pretty well with the bottom of that, so it should be good. This original mounting plate here, it goes to the bottom of that, and on this side it doesn't really go anywhere, so I can't rely on that. The mounting plate seems level. No, my apologies to the manufacturers. This is level. Okay, this is good. This is 48 millimeters down there, 48 millimeters down there. Okay, well that's what I've got. As you can see, it's not level. I've got no choice but to drill out those holes so I can adjust it. Okay, it's all level. I drilled it out 2 millimeters bigger drill bit. So that'll be a 8 millimeter drill bit, but that's too big, but I've got to adjust that. Don't do up these bolts too tight. This is on plastic and you don't want to crack it. Okay, so now I'll wire it all up. We'll see what we've got. If it all works, you know, it's party time. And if it doesn't, then I'm in deep water. Okay, that's the wiring for the other side, so it should be right for this side. Okay, there it is. And that's all lined up with the color chart there. Remember to use paper tape. You don't want any of these wires to touch. Okay, first of all, I'll do driving lights, then brakes, indicator, and reverse. So that's all good. If at this point you're having problems, it's best to go to the start of the video, and that may help around about where I go and show the other color codes where I'm looking through my eBay account there. There are different color codes, and just keep trying. If you're having problems at this point, hopefully it wasn't too hard for you to remove the other reverse brake light and indicator assembly and just put it back on. You may have to resolder it or put it back temporarily until you find out more. Okay, here's a bit of a strange story to you. A couple of days before I put this LED in, the blinkers or indicators started flashing very fast on the way home from work, just for no reason. I got out, I changed the bulb thinking it must be a bulb, and it made no difference. So 2 days later, on the weekend, I put the LED in. That should have started the blinkers flashing fast. So this weekend, a couple of weekends after I put that on, of course this is going to start flashing fast. Because you've got to put a new, I think it's like an indicator relay. So what happens is there's not as much load on the relay, so that recognizes as being a blown globe, but it's not, it's just the LED, and LEDs take up less electricity, so there's less load on your generator, etc. So that's the LED, what are they calling it, blinker indicator flasher. So you'll have to change out your bulb one for this one here, and although you'll still have bulbs in the front indicators, I'm not really sure how that works. I don't know if this works, but I'm assuming this is what you do. You have to exchange out your indicator relay. Okay, before installing these LED lights, this flasher was flashing at the right amount, but the flasher unit is just up under here. You can just hear it there. I don't know if I'll be able to film it. Okay, I don't know if that's in focus or not, but that just there, I'm just going to try and focus that. That, anyway, that's the flasher unit, and that'll have to be changed out for an LED one. You can, if you put your finger on it, you can feel, yeah, you can feel it vibrating. Okay, next part of the job is to solder up the joins and put shrink wrap on the joins. So I've got my soldering iron going now. I don't recommend soldering irons. You can get these little little burners. You push a button and it throws out a small flame, and that's the best and safest way. You can burn yourself with this. If you're going to use a soldering iron, you need to wear gloves, not plastic gloves, leather gloves like that. Okay, this one will be next. That one's done. So this is the driving lights. So with this one, I'll just trim that a bit, it's a bit too long. Okay, first thing you do is to put flux on it. It's a little bit like a type of grease. I don't think it is grease, but you get that at the hardware shop where you get your soldering iron or your burner, a little gas burner or whatever you decide to get. A little bit short, so. Oh, you know what I've forgotten? Don't do that. Don't do what I've done. Must put the shrink wrap on first. And I'll hold that up there with a bit of tape. If it drops down, it won't be good, because the shrink wrap will shrink before you can get it on the join. So this one I can probably, no, that won't work. Did I remember to say to put the soldering iron on some cement sheet and make sure it doesn't move? If it goes onto the carpet, it'll burn it. Okay, I just put my gloves on. Okay, my shrink wrap's already on. That's on. That's done. I'll let that cool down. give it, I don't know, 20 seconds or whatever. Okay, give it a test. And on with the shrink wrap. Got a little lighter here. And just make sure the flame doesn't burn anything else. Okay, and that's done. Okay, I'll show one more. That's the indicator. So, again, same thing, shrink wrap. Make sure you don't breathe these fumes in. Okay, just give a wave around with a hand just to get rid of the fumes. Okay, that is quite important, make you sick. Whatever that means these days. Okay, shrink wrap time. Make sure that's centered over the join there. I'll get it from the other angle there, and that's done. Okay, it's a really good idea at this point to just stand back and test the work that you've done. For instance, this was actually around the wrong way. Okay, so now it's as it should be, and yeah, some of the things you find are a little humbling, but it's better to find them early, and in this case there really was nothing, it was just unscrewing the screws and flipping it around. Okay, we'll do a test. The new one is the one on the left. We've got driving lights, and I'll do indicators, brake lights, and reverse. If you don't want to solder, you can get this duct tape. This makes a fairly good electrical join. It's called duct tape, as in plumbing duct or air conditioning duct, and it just tears like that, and it sticks to itself. You can put the wire in the middle, and you know, it sticks fairly well. It's not the plastic PVC tape. This won't last all that long. Okay, well, I started at say 11:30. It's now 3:15, so you know, that's approximately 4 hours, right? And I'd already done the right hand side one before, and I had problems with that one, with the wiring. So you know, You want to start on a Saturday morning, give yourself plenty of time, do your research. It's going to be a lot easier if you've got the correct wiring color code.